Once again, the familiar drama unfolds. Pakistan takes the global stage at the United Nations, armed with the same tired narrative. Every year, without fail, Pakistan's leaders make it a point to drag India into the spotlight, crying foul over Kashmir, lecturing the world about human rights, and attempting to play the victim card.
What is he going to do when he lifts the curfew? Does he think that people of Kashmir will quietly accept the status quo because India has changed the constitution and taken away the special status? They'll accept that?
Jammu and Kashmir neither is a so-called integral part of India, nor is it India's internal matter.
It's almost like clockwork. Pakistan goes on a rant, and then India's diplomats, with calm and precision, stand up and shut it down. Year after year, Indian envoys have masterfully countered these allegations, presenting the truth and setting the record straight.
Pakistan has ventured to upstream terrorism and downstream hate speech there. India is going ahead with mainstreaming development in Jammu and Kashmir.
That the entire union territories of Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh were, are, and will always be an integral and inalienable part of India. This includes the areas that are under the illegal occupation of Pakistan.
When Pakistan's Prime Minister Shehbaz Sharif, during the 79th session of the UN General Assembly in 2024, raised the Kashmir issue yet again, India didn't stay silent.
Since the 5th of August 2019, India has initiated unilateral illegal steps to impose what its leaders ominously call a final solution for Jammu and Kashmir. Day in and day out, 900,000 Indian troops terrorize the people of occupied Jammu and Kashmir with draconian measures, including prolonged curfews, extrajudicial killings, and the abduction of thousands of young Kashmiris.
This year, it was the powerful response delivered by Bhavika Manglanandan, one of India's youngest diplomats at the UN. Bhavika, an Indian Foreign Service officer, didn't just respond. She tore apart Pakistan's claim with facts, logic, and composure. So what did Pakistan say this time? Prime Minister Shehbaz Sharif stood at the UN General Assembly and brought up Jammu and Kashmir again, referencing Article 370, the revocation of the region's special status, and even glorifying Hizbul commander Burhan Wani. Sharif went as far as comparing the situation in Jammu and Kashmir to that of Palestine, calling for India to reverse its decision on Article 370. But India wasn't going to let this baseless rant go unchallenged. Bhavika, a 2015 batch officer of the Indian Foreign Service and India's first secretary for counter-terrorism at the UN, delivered what could only be described as a diplomatic masterclass. With grace and poise, Bhavika began by calling out Pakistan's hypocrisy. She labeled Sharif's comments as audacious attacks on the world's largest democracy. She didn't mince her words, reminding the world that it is Pakistan, not India, that has consistently used terrorism as a weapon to disrupt peace in Jammu and Kashmir. Let's be clear, Pakistan has a long history of using terrorism as state policy. Bhavika highlighted this, pointing out Pakistan's role in cross-border terrorism, whether it's the attack on India's parliament, the 2611 Mumbai terror attacks, or constant efforts to disrupt elections in Jammu and Kashmir. Pakistan's list of terror-related activities is long and dangerous. Bhavika emphasized that for a country like Pakistan to speak about violence and democracy anywhere in the world is hypocrisy at its worst. Bhavika didn't stop here. She reminded the world that Pakistan was the country that harbored Osama bin Laden, the mastermind behind the 9/11 attacks, and continues to provide safe haven to terrorist organizations that wreak havoc across the globe. But the real punch came when she called out Pakistan's blatant attempts to distort the truth. Bhavika said,
"We know that Pakistan will seek to counter the truth with more lies. Repetition will change nothing. Our stand is clear. and needs no reiteration.
A simple yet powerful message that Pakistan's propaganda machine cannot rewrite history. Now let's take a moment to talk about the women behind this epic response. Who is Bhavika Manglanandan? Bhavika hails from Kochi, Kerala, and she is no stranger to challenges. She cracked the highly competitive UPSC Civil Services exam in a third attempt, securing a rank of 249. A graduate from the IIT Delhi with both a BTech and an MTech, Bhavika initially worked in the private sector before choosing a career in the Indian Foreign Service. Before joining the IFS, she worked as an assistant systems engineer at Tata Consultancy Services and later as a senior engineer at Schneider Electrics, but her calling was diplomacy. And after clearing the UPSC exam, she joined the Ministry of External Affairs in 2015. Since then, Bhavika has represented India across the globe, from serving as second secretary in Belarus to now being India's first secretary for counter-terrorism at the UN. She has proven herself time and again. This movement at the UN is the latest in a journey of making India proud. Her speech didn't just silence Pakistan. It echoed around the world, reminding everyone that India will not stand for falsehoods or threats. In a world filled with challenges, Bhavika Manglanandan's voice was a powerful reminder that truth, diplomacy, and determination are India's strongest weapon on the global stage. Thank you for joining us in dissecting the pivotal moment in international relations, where the search for truth remains paramount and the drive for a more stable and just world never wavers. If you like the video, do not forget to like, share, and subscribe to Indian Masterminds. Thank you for watching.